I told, I work at a fast food company in the legal department. It's kind of a, you know, serious kind of job. I told my boss that I was going to do this, and he said, "Oh, that's right. You told me you were funny." He didn't know this. You know, getting older kind of sneaks up on you. I'm the same age as my house, and I'm doing some remodeling. I can relate to my house, okay? Need a new plumbing. Okay, so a new electrical, definitely. And a new roof. Well, I'm telling my kids that I'm turning blonde again. That's what the gray hair is. Okay, my my mom has Alzheimer's, and that's kind of a sad thing, but we as a family are trying to make it a little more, you know, we're trying to use humor in there. And when she first came here, when she lived in Arizona and I wanted to move her out here, we had her in the home, and she announces to my aunt and I that she has some bad news. "What is it, Mom?" "I am the queen." We said, "Of what?" We had no idea. She said, "Of the United States." She was really sad to hear that she was queen, but was she, you know, was upset when she found out, but now she has to tell everybody. And my aunt and I are like, "Oh my gosh, what is she gonna do?" Well, in the Alzheimer's home, most people are in wheelchairs, so they're all lined up there. My mom comes up, excuse me, no one turns around. "I am your queen." It was horrible, okay? So now she, the doctors decide she has to go to a psych ward. We take her off all of her meds. That was interesting. Just going to the psych ward was interesting because there's like a stigma, you know? I've never been in one, luckily. So we go in there to visit her. My friend comes with me and she says, "Oh, I really like your blouse." And she said, "Oh, thank you." She says, "Can I have it?" And my friend's like, "No, you know, what am I gonna do?" She goes, "I'll give you this." And she's wearing one of those gowns. You know, she didn't want that. And then, this was the clincher, was at the end of the time there, she said, I said, "Mom, how are you doing here?" She goes, "Oh, I really like this place." And she said, "Yeah, I really like it. And I've been talking to the other people here. And when we get out, we're going to get a place together." It was tough. You know, old people do not get technology. I know enough to be dangerous, and I can do some of it. But I don't get this Twitter thing that you guys do, you know? To us, tweet. That was, you know, what birds did. Tweet, tweet, no. We didn't. I don't do tweet. I've seen some of what, you know, you guys write. "Oh, enjoying myself at lunch." Don't care. For older people, it would be something like, "Enjoying myself going to the bathroom." And then a little bit later, "Going back to the bathroom." And then just staying in the bathroom, okay? Do you guys know what Lasix is? You will. Thank you.
Keep it going for Carrie. Checking off that bucket list. I used to have a bucket list. Like, one of my first things that I checked off of a bucket list was to urinate off the side of the Grand Canyon. And I'm proud that I finally achieved that goal. Coming up next, Nick Stadler. Keep it going for Nick Stadler.